हॅलो स्टुडंट्स, वेलकम बॅक टू ऑनलाईन लेक्चर ऑफ एम जी शहा विद्या मंदिर अँड ज्युनियर कॉलेज बाहुबली. वेलकम टू 10th मॅथ्स सेकंड. टॉपिक 3 सर्कल, टचिंग सर्कल्स अँड एक्सरसाइज 3.2. वेलकम स्टुडंट्स इन ऑनलाईन लेक्चर ऑफ 10th मॅथ्स. स्टुडंट्स, इन मॅथ्स सेकंड वी हॅड स्टार्टेड टॉपिक नंबर 3, सर्कल. इन द अर्लियर व्हिडिओ वी हॅड सीन व्हॉट इज मीन बाय टेंजेंट, सिकंड अँड व्हॉट इज द टेंजेंट सेगमेंट. ऑल्सो वी हॅड सीन एक्झाम्पल्स इन प्रॅक्टिस सेट 3.1. स्टुडंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी वन न्यू कन्सेप्ट, दॅट इज टचिंग सर्कल्स. हाऊ इट इज we will see in this lecture. See, touching circles. How circles touch each other? If either they touch externally or they touch internally. In this way, two circles touch each other. So what happens when they touch externally and when they touch internally? We will see here. If the circle touches externally, means see here, this is the circle in center C1. And this is the circle with center C2. These two circles touches externally. Baga external touch karta at point P. Here point of contact is P. Okay. So here we can find distance between their center. See, this is radius. Suppose this circle is radius R1 and this smaller circle radius is R2. So how to find distance between their center? C1 and C2 मधील डिस्टन्स कसं काढणार आपण? R1 प्लस R2. Therefore here you can write distance between center. Distance between center we can find as sum of radii. That is R1 plus R2. Here we find distance between center C1 and C2 by using formula R1 plus R2. Okay. That is when circle touches externally, then we can find the distance between their center by R1 plus R2, sum of the radii. Similarly, here see, this is the larger circle, this is the circle with center C1. And this is smaller circle with center C2. They both touches at point P. Therefore, we can find, suppose this is radius R1, greater circle radius is R1 and this is R1. So, how to find distance between center C1 and C2? Kya distance karna hai? First karna hai, R1 and R2 subtract kar. Okay? So, here, what is the distance? See, distance between center, distance between centers is equal to difference of radius, difference of radius. That is, we write distance between center C1 and C2 is equal to R1 minus R2. Here R1 is greater than R2. Okay? R1 is greater than R2, so the R1 minus R2. This is about circle touches externally and circle touches internally. Here you observe both centers and the point of contact P lie on the same line segment. C1, C2 P ekas लाईनवर आहे, म्हणजे ते तिन्ही पॉईंट काय आहे, को लिनियर आहे. ओके, इथं ऑब्झर्व करा, C1, C2 आणि पॉईंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट दे लाय ऑन द सेम लाईन, दॅट इज दीज 3 पॉईंट आर को लिनियर पॉईंट. यू रिमेंबर दॅट थिंग ऑल्सो. ओके, यू रिमेंबर दिस डिस्टन्स बिटवीन सेंटर अँड यू रिमेंबर फॉर टचिंग सर्कल एक्सटर्नली अँड टचिंग सर्कल इंटरनली, सेंटर अँड पॉईंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट, सेंटर अँड पॉईंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट लाय ऑन द same plane, that is they are collinear points. Now we will see examples, based on it. See examples in practice 3.2. What is the first question? Two circles having radius 3.5 cm and 4.8 cm touch each other internally. Find the distance between their center. Here, two circles are touching internally. Okay, so what is the distance between their center? Difference of the radius. Okay, I have told you. So here, let R1 is equal to 4.8 cm and R2 is equal to 3.5 cm are the radius of two circles. Now, for touching circles, we know that for touching circles, what is the for touching circles? Centers and point of contact. Point of contact lie on same line or collinear. They are collinear. Okay, they are collinear. These three points are collinear. Therefore, distance between their center. Their centers is equal to, this is for circle touching internally, difference of radius, that is difference between radius. Okay, so how to find difference? 4.8 minus 3.5 is equal to 1.3. So difference between their center is 1.3 centimeter. Okay. Similarly, second question is there. Two circles of radius is given. Touch each other. Here, what is the question? Touch each other externally. Here, externally. Find the distance between their center. 5.5 cm and 4.2 cm touch each other externally. Find the distance between their center. So here actually you suppose R1 is equal to 5.5 cm and R2 is equal to 4.2 cm. Okay. Here actually you write the same line. For touching circles, center and point of contact are collinear. Therefore, distance between circles touching externally is equal to sum of the radii. So what is the sum? 5.5 plus 4.2 is equal to 9.7 cm. So you remember, if the circle touches internally, then their center, distance between their center is difference between radii. And if the circle touches externally, distance between centers of circle touching externally is sum of the radii. Okay. See question number 3. If radii of two circles are 4 cm and 2.8 cm, draw the figure of the circles touching externally and internally. Question 3, you can draw yourself. Radius is given, R1 is given 4 and R2 is given 2.8 cm. You have to draw a figure using compass box. Internal is touch the right side and
externally touch the circle kare che. You can draw yourself, okay? Now we will see question number 4. What is the question number 4 given? See, in figure the circle with center P and Q touch each other at point R. It touch each other at point R. A line passing through R meets at circle at point A and at point B. Yanga hai nahi. We have to show that first. What we have to find first? AP, segment AP is parallel to 2B. We have to find first. Then second, triangle APR, single triangle RQB. We have to find. And last one we have to find, if angle PAR is equal to 35 degree, we have to find angle RQB. Okay? So we will start here. See, first we have to prove AP is parallel to QB. So for proving parallelogram, we need alternate angle test or corresponding angle test. Okay, we had seen. So here, see first, R is between point A and B. Why? Because theorem of touching circle. Theorem of touching circles. If you use a point touching circle, then the two points and this R are in the, or here, which points? Sorry, P, R, Q. P, R, Q are in the R points collinear. Okay? Now, see, we have to try to first PQ is parallel to QB. So here, in this triangle, in this circle, see, circle with center P. See, in circle with center P, that is in triangle. In triangle APR. In this triangle, AP, segment AP is congruent to segment PR. Why? Because these are the radii. Radii of same circle are congruent. These are the radii of same circle. Okay? So these are the congruents. So opposite angle is also congruent. So what is angle? Angle PAR. PAR. Congruent angle ARP. Okay, reason why isoscale triangle theorem. Isoscale triangle theorem. Okay. So these are the congruent. You call this as equation number first. Similarly, in triangle BQR, BQR, in this triangle also these are two congruents. We can prove that angle QRB, angle QRB is congruent to angle QBR. You call this as equation number second. Okay, first step, these two radii are congruent, therefore angles, base angles are congruent. These two radii are congruent, therefore these base angles are congruent. We call this number second. But here, so these are the vertically opposite angles. Which see ARP? Which angle? But angle ARP is congruent with angle. Which angle? QRB. QRB. Because these are opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Okay? These are vertically opposite angles. We call this equation number third. Now observe equation 1, 2, and 3. These two are congruent, these two angles are congruent, and these two angles are congruent. Therefore,
This angle and this angle are congruent. Which angle from equation 1, 2 and 3? We can write angle PAR. Angle PAR is congruent to angle RQBR. QBR. Okay? So, these angles are congruent. So these are angles are C, this is Z shape, these angles are alternate angles. Alternate angles are congruent. If the alternate angles are congruent, then the lines are parallel. Therefore, segment AP is parallel to segment BQ. Why? Because alternate angle test. Alternate angle test. According to an alternate angle test, because these angles are congruent, therefore sides are parallel. We will prove first, okay? Then second, for second, this is for first, okay? Triangle APR, this triangle first, and triangle R, this is the second triangle. We have to prove these two triangles are similar. Now, in triangle APR and triangle RQP. In these four triangles, see which angles are congruent from equation 1 and 3. Observe equation 1 and 3, you can write PAR is congruent with PAR is congruent with ARP and ARP is congruent with QRP. Okay, so we write first the angle PAR. Congruent to angle QRP. This is from equation 1 and 3. Observe equation 1 and 3. Equation 1 is this. Okay. PAR is congruent with ARP and ARP is congruent with QRP. Therefore, PAR and QRP are congruent. Second, similarly, from equation 2 and 3. QRB is congruent with QBR and QBR is congruent with QRB and QRB is congruent with ARP. Therefore, we can write angle ARB is congruent to angle QBR from equation 2 and 3. Therefore, you can write from this equation, these two angles are congruent of these both triangles. Therefore, by A test, these two triangles are similar by A similarity test. According to A similarity test, these both triangles are congruent. Which triangle? C, A, R. Angle A la congruent kunta hai R. And angle R la kunta hai B. R la B. Remains P, here remains Q. Therefore, these both triangles are congruent. We prove the second. And lastly, third, angle PAR is given 35. Then, what is the angle RQB? RQB is what we have to prove. Okay. See, this angle is 35 degrees. So this is 35. This is opposite, therefore it is also 35. And these two angles are congruent, therefore it is also 35. So we have to find this angle. Okay. Now, in triangle BQR, angle, see angle QRB, QRB plus angle QBR plus angle RQB is equal to 180 degree. QRB is 35 degree plus 35 degree plus angle RQB is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, 70 degree plus angle RQB is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle RQB is equal to 180 degree minus 70 degree. Angle RQB is 180 degree. Okay, so students, for these two lines are parallel, we do first term. These two radii are congruent, therefore angles, base angles are congruent. These two radii are congruent, therefore base angles are congruent. So these are the two vertical angles. So we know that these two angles are congruent. If these two angles are congruent, the dead angles are alternate angles. So these two lines are parallel. These two triangles are too similar by showing two angles are congruent. And last we find angle PAR, the RQB, 180. See last question in practice 3.2. In figure, circle with center A and B touches each other at point E. These two circles touches at point E. Suppose this is point E. Okay. Line L is tangent which touches circle at point C and D. This is the line L, which touches the circle at point C and D. Find the length of CD if the radii of the circle are 4 and 6 centimeter. Here, we have given radii is 4 and 6. We have to find it. What we have to find here? See, we have to find CD, length of the segment CD. We have to find. Okay, and radii are given. So we join this. Radii are given, 4 cm, smallest circle radius is 4 and greater circle radius is 3 cm. And this is the point E, point of contact. So we have to find CD. Where is CD? See here. For this, we use construction. You join CD points and DB. Okay? First, in the solution of we join segment AC and segment BD or DB. Okay. Also, we do construction. Draw. What we draw? See here. Draw. Here, take some points such that it is perpendicular. Okay. Point as F. Draw AF perpendicular to DB. Draw AF perpendicular to DB such that AFB. Okay. So see here, AC is perpendicular to A. AC is radius and CD is tangent. Therefore, from figure we can write as from figure AC is perpendicular to CD and BD is perpendicular to CD. Why? This is because of tangent theorem. What says the tangent theorem? Tangent and radius are perpendicular to each other. Tangent and radius are perpendicular to each other. Therefore, we write angle ACD is equal to 90 degree and angle BDC is equal to 90 degree. Angle BDC means angle FDC. That is, this shows angle FDC is equal to 90 degree. Now see in this quadrilateral. Now in quadrilateral ACDF, angle C is 90 degree, angle D is angle F is also, angle F is also 90 degrees. Therefore, angle A becomes angle A means CAF is also becomes 90 degrees. Sum of the all angles of quadrilateral is 90 degrees. Therefore, CAF is also 90 degrees. Okay. Now, all these angles are right angle. Therefore, quadrilateral ACDF is a rectangle. Why? Because all angles are 90 degrees. Therefore, it is a rectangle. This is 90, this is 90, this is 90, and this is also 90. Therefore, this quadrilateral is a rectangle. So, for rectangle, opposite sides are congruent. This 4 cm, this is also 4 cm. So, AC, therefore, AC is equal to DF because opposite sides of rectangle, opposite sides of rectangle are congruent. AC is 4, therefore, DF is equal to 4 cm. And BE is equal to BD. BE is equal to BD. Same reason, opposite sides of rectangle are congruent. So, what is BE? BE means BF plus FB. BF plus FB is equal to BD is 6 cm. 6. Therefore, see here DF. DF is 4 cm. Okay, DF. BF plus, what is DF? DF is 4 is equal to 6. Therefore, BF becomes 2 cm. BF becomes 4 cm. Okay? So, BF is 2. Now, BF becomes 2 cm. And this hole is, AB is 10 cm. Now, in triangle ABF, ABF, angle F is equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, according to Pythagoras theorem, according to Pythagoras theorem, what do we say that according to Pythagoras theorem? Here, this angle is 90. Therefore, opposite vertex is the hypotenuse. AB is hypotenuse. So we write as AF square plus FB square is equal to AB square. So what is AF? We don't know. AF square plus what is FB? 2 square. And what is AB? 4 plus 6 in square. Therefore, AF square plus 4 is equal to 100. Therefore, AF square is equal to 100 minus 4. Therefore, we get AF square as 96. That is, AF square is equal to 66 and 96. Taking square root on both sides, we get AF is equal to 16 square root is 4 root 6. Therefore, we get AF as 4 root 6. We get AF as 4 root 6, and AF and CD are congruent, but AF is equal to CF because opposite sides of rectangle, therefore AF and CD, so we get CD, therefore we get CD as 4 root 6 cm. So we have to find the length of CD. We get length of CD as 4 root 6 cm. Okay, so student, here we completed question number 5. In this video, we had seen what is mean by touching circles. If the circle touches each other externally, Then distance between their center is equal to sum of the radius, and if the circle touches internally, then we find the distance between their center by difference of the radii. Also, we have seen examples in practice set 3.2. So, students, your today's homework is solve practice set 3.2 in your notebook. Okay, thank you. See you in the next video.